The revolutionary Beatles, who claim they were more popular than Jesus Christ, is no longer together, but their music effectively lives on. In Abbey Road, they has a picture of the four Beatles walking across the street. And the third Beatle back is Paul McCartney. And as we look at that album, there's something different about him than the rest of the men. He's walking across the street in bare feet. Now, the reason behind that is in London or in England, it's tradition to bury someone in bare feet. That only added to the rumor that the Beatles were trying to spread that Paul was dead. And the reason I say that is because at the end of one of their songs, they subliminally inject in a faded voice, "Paul is dead." I want you to listen to that for a moment. They said, "I buried Paul," to try to confirm the rumor that Paul was dead. Now, it goes further than that, because the Beatles, through their lyrics and lifestyles, have introduced millions to transcendental meditation and Hare Krishna. They have glorified drug use through songs like Strawberry Fields Forever. Strawberry Fields. How did that glorify drug use? What they're talking about, the strawberry fields are the red marks that are left in your arm from withdrawing and putting in the needle that would puncture your arm. Those red marks are the strawberry fields that they're referring to. They glorify drug use through the song, "Hey Jude." Listen.
Remember to let her under your skin.
Remember to let her under your skin, then you'll begin to make it better, better, better. What do you suppose they're talking about to let under your skin to make it better? Then they came out with Lucy in the Skies with Diamonds. They advertised that song with the abbreviations on billboards as LSD. The Beatles sang about their Lord. They sang "My Sweet Lord." Many of us have sung along with that song. But in the middle of the song, they subliminally inject who their Lord really is. First, I want you to familiarize yourself with what the song sounds like. I know that doesn't sound all that bad. But I want you to listen closely, because when you hear the next portion of the song, instead of the alleluias in between "My Sweet Lord," they sing who their Lord is, and it's Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna is a form of Hinduism, and that's who their Lord is. Listen. Good example of subliminal injection. They go on to sing in the song, after they declare who their Lord is, Hare Krishna, they sing, "My sweet Lord, I really want to see you, I really want to see you."